Hi friends, in this video we will discuss about the Python class 2. To do the practicals, edit plus, go to the file menu, click on new. To write some points, just let me take the Python panel, go to the new others, in others select the Python. This is called Python window. Here you can write some points. This is about the Python class 2. So class by class I will give all the points. Class 1 to class 150 at the class. I'll upload all the class on YouTube just to check the all the classes. This is Python class 2, right? That's it. In Python class 2, we'll discuss about. So I hope in your machine Python is installed, right? If you have any installation problems, just check the installation video. Check the installation video, right? That's it. So once the Python installation is done properly, then you will discuss different ways to run the Python application. So generally in the student level and in the project level, we have the different ways to run the Python file, right? We'll discuss all the approaches, approach by approach, check it out. Approach one, to run the Python file. What is approach number one here? Once you install the Python, by default the file goes to local disk C. But in my system, I'm using my own location. In local disk E, I'm saving my file. In local disk E, you can check it. Once you install the Python, you will get the Python folder. Python 3.6 is there. So Python 3.6 is called a installation directory, right? That's it. In the installation directory, to work with the Python, you have directly Python exe file. This is called exe file here. Just open the Python exe file. Then what happened here? Exe file is running, right? Here directly you can type the commands. What are the commands you want? Generally the students, they're following this approach, right? I want RatanVold. Just simply can go with the RatanVold, right? Click on enter button. RatanVold is printed. A equal 10, simply can write the print of A. 10 is printed. So this is the one of the approach to do the Python practicals. What is the approach here? Go to the installation folder, approach number one. So installation folder, Python exe file, right? We have to click on Python exe file. Once you click on the Python exe file, then what happened here? In the command prompt will be opened. In the command prompt, you can do the practicals, right? This is the first approach. The point is clear, right? Good. So this is installation directory. Next one is approach number two. What is approach number two? Tell me any idea. Once installation is done properly, simply you can go with the IDLE. So Python IDLE is open. Just click on IDLE. You'll get the IDL option. Integrated Development Environment, right? Simply can say IDLE. Good. Language Environment. That's it. So in IDLE, directly here, you can do the practicals. Print off. Simply can write RatanVold, right? That's it. RatanVold is printed. Otherwise, A equal 10. Simply can write the print of A. A is printed. 10 is printed. So in IDLE, this is the one way to run. And the second way, if you want to write the multiple lines of code, go to the file menu, click on new file. Once you click on new file, then what happened here? One notepad type editor is opened here. In the notepad type editor type, here write the files. What are the file? This is my RatanVold. Tell me, this is my RatanVold. Next one is what? This is my print RatanVold, right? That's all. Then simply can save it, control S. Save some location. As you know, how to save the Python application here? Save the Python application always .py extension. So any location you can go, local disk E, I'm saving my file. The file is called first dot, the extension should be .py. See, slowly we are discussing, just observe the point, take the laptop, do the practicals with me. So I know, yeah? Take the video and do the practicals in your system, right, properly. Then again check the just first dot .py, save it. Okay, so already existed, you can replace it, that's not a problem. After saving, go to the run option, run. You can run module actually. Come on, here in the classroom means one time we are watching the class, right? In the live classes means only one time you can check it. But video means if you want any number of times, just you can check the video multiple times, right? Just click on run module. Then output is what? RatanVold is printed or not? Yes or no? That's it. This is the second approach to run the Python applications, right? Approach number two. What is that approach number two here? IDLE. Otherwise in IDLE, new file concept is there. So how many approaches done? Two approaches. Approach one, directly in Python installation folder, exe file is there. Just click on exe file, you will get the data, right? So what is the second approach here? Go to the IDLE. In the IDLE, we can write the application directly. This is approach number two. And approach number three here, coming to approach number three. See, once in your system, Python initialization is done, we have to set the path. We have to set the path to work with the command prompt. See, for example, in my system already path is there. Open the Python command prompt. Just select the Python. You'll get the Python prompt here directly. Open your normal command prompt. In the normal command prompt, just to type the Python, you'll get the Python Python angular braces, right? But in your machine, you may get Python is not recognized internal external command. It means in your system Python is there, but path setting you have to do. See, to work with the command prompt, always you have to set the path actually. Then sir, how to set the path? Path setting is very easy process. Go to the initialization folder. In my system local disk E, we have the initialization folder, right? You have the Python 3.6. In the Python 3.6, just to copy this location. Right click on my computer. Simply can go with the properties. Advanced system settings, environmental variables. So in my system is already path is there, right? You just click on in your machine means initially you have to click on new, type the variable name is path, variable value up to location, that's it. Up to location, right? So in my system already Java is there, Java path, next Python path is there, this is Python path. So multiple path means the path operator is semicolon. So in your machine you may have only path option, right? Just you can type the variable name is path, variable value just this location, that's it. Only E Python 3.6. Click on OK. Once you've done this process, just open the new command prompt. Just to type the Python, you'll get the Python window directly here. Once you'll get the Python window, directly you can write the print message, print return world, right? That's it. Directly can do it, right? That's it. A equal 10, simply can write the message is print of A, right? Print of A, that's all. So this is the approach number, how much? Approach number 3. What approach number 3 here? In the command prompt, just to type which command here? Type Python. Then what happened here? Command prompt, when we type the Python, to do this process, we have to set the path first of all. Set the path, right? That's all, guys. This is approach number 3, right? That's all. Next approach, tell me, approach number 4. Come on here, in the classroom, there is no students. The classroom in front of the camera, I'm assuming you guys are available, then I'm teaching here. So don't cheat, Radhan sir. Just in front of you, take your laptop, do the practicals properly, and share the information to your friends. Then your friends also get benefited, right? Sir, no, yeah, that's it. Approach number 4. What is the approach number 4 here? Normal approach here. In approach number 4, just open Edit Plus. So to do the practicals of Python, sometimes I'm using Edit Plus here. Just open Edit Plus. In the Edit Plus, to write the application, install Edit Plus software here. Okay, install Edit Plus, go to the file menu, click on new. I want others, in others I want Python. Just to click on OK. This is called Python window. Here write the files here. How to write the file here? The print of, tell me print of, this is my Ratan world. Tell me print of Ratan world. Print of Ratan world. Some guys are saying Ratan sir spelling mistake. Feeling important there. Spelling's not important. Feeling important, right? That's it. So print of Ratan world, Ratan world. How many times I'm writing here? 2 times. Just to save it. How to save? Control S. Go to this particular location, so and so location. Here file name. What is the file name here? You can give any file name, but the extension should be .py. Python files, how to save here? Extension should be .py. C language means dots. In my system is already file is available. It is asking the message. Do you want to replace it? Yes. C language means .c extension. CPP means .cpp extension. Java means .java extension. Python means .py extension. server. This is first dot py. I want run this file. To run this file, command prompt. Where is your file is there initially? In local disk E, your file is there, right? But control is showing which location? Local disk C. First of all, move to the local disk E, E colon. E means what? E colon, right? That's all. Local disk E. The next one is, we have to you have to run that file, right? To run the file, the command is called Python. Python space, which file you want run here? First dot py. Then what is the output you will get here? Ratan world and Ratan world, right? Sir, no, Ratan world and Ratan world. So this is the way how to run the file from the command prompt. I hope the points are clear, right? So you can save the application in the edit plus, run the application from the command prompt. This is approach number how much here? Approach number 4. What is approach number 4 here? Save the application in edit plus. In edit plus, so run the application on. Tell me, save the application in edit plus. So run the application from, tell me, run the application from command prompt, right? That's it. Four approaches clear. Approach one, we have to go to the initialization folder directly Python exe file. Approach number two, IDLE. In the IDLE, you can directly type the application. Otherwise, in the new file also, you can type the application. Approach number three, command prompt. In the command prompt, directly you can type the command is called Python. But to do this application, we have to set the path first of all. Approach number four, save the application in edit plus. Save the application in edit plus. Run the application from the command prompt. This is the way how to run the application, right? That's all, guys. Next one is approach number five. Some of the students are saying, Ratan sir, in my system Python is not working properly. In your system, some cases Python is not working properly, some virus problem, your Python files are corrupted, but you won't do the practicals immediately. To do the practicals immediately, simply can go to the online compilers also. Come on, yeah. See, I'm working for Python. I want Java testing. Java testing means don't install the Java, right? Just you can go to the online compiler. In the online compiler, simply can write the application or not. In the same way, in my system, Python is not working properly. Just I can go with the Python online compiler. Simply can type the Python, Python online compiler. The better window is the Repl software, REPL. Just click on enter button. So just click on Python Repl. Then workspace is open. In the workspace, you can just for testing purpose here. In this workspace, directly can run the applications, right? Here directly can run it. So print off, simply can write Ratan world, right? Print off Ratan world. Sir, no? Good. Here you have the run option here. Just click on run option. Then what is the output you will get here now? Yeah, what is the output now you will get here? Ratan world, right? Internet is slow, I don't think application is slow. Just for the checking purpose, directly can go with the Repl software, do this application. This is approach number how much here? Approach number 5. Simply can go with the online compilers, right? That's it. And the last approach, approach number 6. Approach number 6, we can use the ID here, PyCharm ID. Actually, at the end of the classes, 5-6 classes, you will do with ID also. What are the ID general we are using? PyCharm ID. This is PyCharm ID to do the practicals, right? So I'll show the ID approaches later here. Once I install the ID, I'll show that approach. Just I'll show that ID. What is the ID I'm using here? You have to go for the PyCharm. Simply can type which one here. So PyCharm download. So PyCharm is given by JetBrains company. So he's the vendor actually. This is called PyCharm symbol. So I will do some of the practicals at the end of the Python by using this PyCharm also. So total, how many ways are there to run this Python code here? Total 6 different ways are there actually. So this is Python exe file directly, IDLE option, otherwise command prompt, type the Python command directly, can we can work with that one. To do this command prompt Python, we have to set the path anyhow. Approach number 4, save the application edit plus. It means write the application edit plus, run the application from the command prompt. But to this 3 and 4th approaches, to work with these 3 and 4th approaches, we have to set the path. Somewhere, because third and fourth approaches, we have to run the application from the command prompt, right? The command prompt required the path setting actually. That is the reason mandatory we have to set the path. The fifth approach is online compiler, sixth approach is IDE, right? That's all, guys. So this is a way. This is a way how to run the Python file in different ways. Guys, just pause the video, take the pen and paper, write all the points. Otherwise, along with the video, do the practicals. So no, yeah, that's all, guys. And comment the video and like the video. And if you have any doubts, just you can mail to my mail ID pythonbyrathan@gmail.com. I'll check that mail ID and I will forward the documents and whatever the documents you want. So no, yeah, that's all. That's all. These are different ways to run the Python code, right? That's all. Next one is the comments in Python. Yeah. Comments in Python. Tell me here, what is the purpose of comments? As you know, comments, right? C language comments, CVP comments, Java comments, like that. Python also have the comments, right? What is the purpose of comments? See, today I am developing application here. I know Python very well. I written the code very. I will apply the more logics. I applied the for loop, inside the for loop, one more for loop, one more for loop, one more for loop. How many for loops I written here? 4 for loops. After 1 month, is regarding with some issues, I resign that company. Once I resign that company, that code is maintained by some other person, right? If the code is maintained by some other person, means he know only basics of Python. He is my student, assume. He know only basics of Python. What he will do? I written for loop, for loop, for loop, for loop, right? Immediately will get no idea regarding that for loops or not. Yes or no? Any idea regarding for loops? No. Once if I write the proper comments. So now, once I read the proper comments, at least you'll get some 50% for 50%, right? Like this is the for loop for this reason, this is the for loop for this reason, this is the for loop for this reason. At least he'll get the 50% subject, 50% knowledge. Then immediately 50% you can think, right? So the main intention of comments is the project maintenance. Maintenance will become easy. Other guys can easily understand your logics. That guys easily can modify that logics. So the main importance of comments, the application maintenance will become easy, right? That's it. See, comments are executable code or non-executable code, yeah? Comments are always non-executable code, right? Comments are non-executable codes, yeah? That's it. But I'm against to theory. So in front of the board, in front of the camera, in the board, explaining, I'm against to the theory. Always I'm going to practicals. You want theory or practicals, guys? Always believes practical knowledge but not theoretical. Practical knowledge, yeah? So if you have to apply your knowledge in the project level, so try to do the practicals, more practicals. You are not going to write an exam, right? That's it, yeah. How many types of comments in Python mainly? What are the two types of comments, yeah? What are two types of comments? One is a single line comments. One is a single line comments. The second one is the multi-line comments, right? Single line and multi-line comments. Single line comments means you can write the description only within the single line. Starts with a hash. Hash, you can write the statement, right? How many statements allowed here? Only one statement. This is called single line comments. Whatever multi-line comments, you can write the description in more than one line. You can write the description in more than one line, right? That's it. So now, yeah, you can write the description in more than one line. This is called multi-line comments. So in multi-line comments in Python, it starts with triple quotes. Triple quotes, write the comments, triple quote closing. So now, yeah, you can write triple quotes. And wherever the triple quotes is there in Python, you can make it 3 single quotes also. Comments, 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 you can write the single quotes. Tell me, Python's comments are executable code or non-executable code, yeah? Non-executable code. These are ignored during compilation itself, right? That's all. How many types of comments we have? Two types. What are two types here? Single line and multi line comments, right? Sir, no, yeah? That's all, guys. Any doubts? Good. The last point regarding this video, we will discuss the keywords. Python, how many keywords in Python here? This is the video class number 2, right? This is the video class number 2. So like that, I'm making the classes, class wise, class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5, class 6, up to class 100 keywords. See, in Java, other languages, if you take other languages, always what happened, in the previous version, we have some keywords means, in the new version, some new keywords are added means, then what happened, old keyword plus new keywords, right? It means the old keywords already exist in the new version also. Sano, yeah? Old keywords are not removed, right? Those already exist in the new version also, right? Yes or no? That's it. But Python is not like that. Python version to version, some keywords are added, some keywords are removed. Yes or no? Yeah? So don't think all the keywords which are there in the 2.x may not present in 3.x. So version to version, the keywords will be changed. So to check the version to version keywords are changed, before going to the keywords, I'll give some information regarding printing, print function here, print actually. To print the data in the 2.7 version, in my system there is no 2.7, let me go with the online compiler. So simply can go with the Python 2.7 online compiler, simply can go to the tutorial point, no problem. So here simply can type the file, this is the 2.0, right? Simply can write the Rathan world, but while writing Rathan world, without parenthesis, I will write the Rathan world here. Simply can execute here, you will get the output is Rathan world, right? Here parenthesis required or not required? Yeah? Not required. So print, so in 2.7, in 2.7, parenthesis required or not required? Yeah? Not required. But the same file you can write in 3.x, this is the online compiler 3.x. Write the code without parenthesis. Write the code without a parenthesis, right? That's it. Without parenthesis, simply can run it, you'll get error message. Parenthesis is syntax error. Which syntax error? Missing parenthesis in call to print, right? It means parenthesis mandatory or optional? Parenthesis here. Parenthesis mandatory or optional? Parenthesis mandatory optional, yeah? Mandatory, right? In 3.x. So the reason, what is the reason? I will tell you the reason. This was mandatory entry question, yeah. So print of here parenthesis mandatory optional here, mandatory. This is which version onwards here? 3.x. Like 3 points. Parenthesis required or not required here? Required. So what is the reason you will discuss in the two finally decided 2.7 parenthesis are optional, 3.x parenthesis are mandatory. What is the reason you will discuss that reason? So to understand that reason, first let me check the keywords. To check the keywords, we have one command here, keywords list, kw list. To check that kw list, how to check the keywords, how to check the keywords? Let me open the online compiler once. Here let me check the keywords. The print of, print of, we required on module actually to check the keywords, import keyword module actually, this is a keyword module to check the keywords, keyword data, the function is called kwlist, so automatically showing the data, right? So these are the keywords which are present in the 3.x, right? Sir, no, yeah? These are the keywords which are present in 3.x. So let me show all the points. So in 3.x keywords, right? Like 3.6 I'm using here. Anyway, 3.6 keywords. 3.6 keywords, right? Just 3.6 keywords here. The same way, let me check the keywords which are present in the 2.7. In 2.7 keywords, right? This is 3.6. Observe carefully. Do the practicals along with me. So in 2.7 keywords. In the 2.7, what are the keywords here? Yeah? So copy the same code, you can make it in the 2.x. Parenthesis required or not required here? Parenthesis are not required, just you can execute it. You will get the keywords like this. So these are the keywords which are present in the 2.7, right? Very good. So these are the keywords which are present in the 2.7. Then here parenthesis required or not required, only the point, parenthesis are not required, right? That's it. These are the key in front of you. I'm placing the keywords in the 2.7, keywords in the 3.x, right? So to check the keywords, print keyword.kw list, keywords list like this you have to use. But you can observe one point here. What we're discussing in the 2.7 params is not required, 3.x params is required, right? The reason is, in the 2.7, you can check the print is a keyword here to print the data. Here, where is the print? This is a print. In the 2.7, print is the keyword to print the data. You get the point here? So in 2.7, print is a keyword to print the data. Keyword to print the data. Print is the keyword to print the data means, then here parentheses mandatory optional, yeah? Parentheses are simply optional, right? That's it, guys. In 2.7, print is the keyword to print the data. So parentheses are simply can say optional. Whatever prints to 3.x, 3.6, any print function, print keyword is there? No, you can check it here. There is no print, right? Print is removed from the 3.x actually. In the 3.x, print is available or not available? Yeah, not available, print is removed. So from 3.x version onwards, so in 3.x, so print is a function to print the data. Function to print the data, right? Function to print the data means here parentheses mandatory optional here. Parentheses are mandatory. I hope you will get some clarity, right? Parentheses are mandatory, right? That's it. So what is the conclusion here? So in the 2.7, parentheses are optional because in the 2.7, print is a keyword to print the data. So parentheses not required. But from the 3.x version onwards, print is not a keyword. It is removed from the 3.x. I said, right, some of the keywords are added, some of the keywords are removed. Yes or no? So that's the reason. So from the 3.x version onwards, print is the function to print the data. So that's the reason parentheses mandatory optional here, mandatory. I hope you guys are getting some clarity, right? The removed keywords here, removed from 3.x, which are present in the 2.7. The best example is a printer. Print which is present in the 2.7 but is removed from the 3.x, right? Removed in 3.x. Removed from 3.x. And the keywords which are added in the 3.x. Which keywords are added here? I think is false is added, none is added, true is added, and non-local is added. You can check it once. True which is not there in the 3.x, none is also not there, true is not there. And one more thing is there, non-local, which is not present in the 2.7 actually. So finally decided non-local is introduced in which version here? 2.3.x, right? So some of the keywords are added, some of the keywords are removed from the new versions, right? That's all, guys. So then finally, what is the conclusion here? So this is all about the Python class number 2. What is the class number 2? What we discussed here? Different ways to run the Python file. So directly can go to the initialization directory Python 3.6. You have the Python exe file, directly can run it. Approach number 2, you can go with the IDLE. Please guys, can please share the information to your friends. Give the good knowledge to your friends also. I think I'm sharing good knowledge to you guys. And write the comments and subscribe to our channel to get the more updates and inform to your friends and college students. Can please pass information to your entire class. Just go to the dais, just say, see Python 1, you want Python, we just check it. That's all. This is called command prompt, this is called save the application, edit plus, run the application from the command prompt. This is called online compiler, so you can go with IDE, PyCharm IDE, you can work. Comments in Python, total how many types of comments in Python here? Single line comment, multi line comments. And printer, to print the data in 2.7 parentheses is not required. The reason is 2.7 print is the keyword to print the data. In 3.x print is a function to print the data. So parentheses is mandatory. That's all, guys. So any doubts regarding this video? So take the pen and paper, write all the points step by step. Here it seems to be 20 minutes or 30 minutes of video. But in the classroom, to take this all the points, to dictate the notes, to write the notes, it will take 1.5 hours, right? Sir, no, I hope you attended Python class somewhere, right? Then you can check it once. Clear? So guys, can check the remaining videos also. to get the more knowledge, right? Thanks guys, thanks for watching. Bye.